Oh, are we live now?
And, no.
Nope.
Now we are.
Where's Sophie?
He's dead. We sacrificed him to kill to save us.
Honestly, not a bad idea.
Jordan!
But absolutely. He's not here to defend himself. We're gonna sacrifice you next.
Yeah.
I mean, that's kind of where we're going.
President.
It's kind of it sucks because at any point for when Rory returns, you guys, we have to just stop what we're doing so that we can return to what he's up to. But last I checked, she is a 27 or a 24. Doesn't really matter. Nothing that any of or no, it was 27. Or actually, none of it matters because no matter what, she would have been higher than all three of you.
Hey, rude.
Not even a welcome. Can we get a welcome in the chat?
Oh, yeah.
Hey, what's up, guys?
It's been several weeks. I hope everyone's doing all right.
Happy New Year.
Happy New Year. Merry Christmas.
Happiest of New Year's.
Happy holidays.
Yeah.
Whatever whatever holiday celebrates death, we can count on that one coming soon.
No!
Happy Cinco de Mayo.
The other people nearby have taken to hiding in the farther.
Oh, we're jumping right in.
Yeah, they are in the.
Not farther... even a recap.
I know. Like, damn.
You know. Okay, we were literally just talking about what happened, but for those of who
we were literally just talking about what happened.
Last session, these three have or four, softens a little preoccupied at the moment. Came into contact with the Grieving Moon as they were trying to escape with prisoners held by the Grieving Moon and her subordinates. She, being upstairs and watching a film, was distracted up until the film had ended, and as they were leaving, they were stopped in their tracks as the only entrance that they know about has been shut off, blocked by her body. She is a tall woman clad in a bridal kimono. Her eyes are empty, just black sockets. She has her handkerchief hanging at her hand now. That was once white, is now stained a dark crimson red that she's been using to whip the few of you. Chi, you are the only one left, and seeing as I believe we either cut the initiative order after you guys had taken damage to cut to Mitsurugi, I'm just gonna restart us because she has an action. But the other citizens that you guys had saved have now taken to hiding. She doesn't seem far too concerned. She seems very much so attracted to Chi's visage.
Me too.
Anyone else?
Me too.
I hate you.
Me too.
All of you.
Hey.
We should get like a boo soundboard so we can boo you.
So, yeah, I'm a little quiet.
Just a boo.
I can turn myself up. I don't know
turn
why
up.
I would be quiet though. People
I feel like every
know.
Stream we have this issue.
Yeah. Hopefully. What was that?
I don't know. Crackly. Sorry, Pearl shook her head and it hit my head.
Pearly.
They're also demanding a Riz check from
Mitsurugi. Yeah, go ahead.
Oh, it's your time to shine.
I'm gonna be sick.
Give you some applause.
Five. Thank you, thank you. Please hold your applause. We should get a drum roll.
Oh, yeah.
No.
Why not?
Grant, I have to live.
Oh my
god. Just got a nat 20.
Well, as soon as you did that, Rory joined. You summoned him with your Riz.
Yeah.
Thank god. That's
what happens every time. Roll the Riz check.
I got a 20. Nat 20, baby.
Bree.
Jesus, starting strong. Jesus.
Yeah.
That's the only 20 I'm gonna get.
We'll do one round of combat. Starting with the three of you, simply because I do believe she was the last person to move. She attacked you guys. So, Tsukihi,
yeah,
Mitsurugi,
mm-hmm.
Chi, you're up. But what was the damage that you guys took? What are you at health-wise now?
I'm not telling you.
So,
I definitely took 11 from the one that knocked me back. I don't know if
you
I took
11?
Any damage. Yeah, I don't know if I took any damage the first time she hit me and cut my jaw,
no,
my
she
neck.
Didn't. Jordan, okay. Perfect. Thank you for telling me exactly how much she did, because I need to now calculate or read the medical attention.
How much it'll take to kill you.
Jordan, you're bleeding internally, and if you do not find some way...
Whoa. Fucking God.
Or, why?
You have a laceration. If you've taken over 11 damage, you're just bleeding. There's a large bleeding cut. Raquel, if you took anything similar to that, let me know.
How much did you take, Raquel? Nine.
You're still also sustaining a very large bleeding cut. This does need some medical attention, but I do know you have a special little ability.
Yeah, let me sit down and figure it out.
Do you have any medical equipment on you right now?
Always.
Do you want to use your reaction point to administer it, or do you want to try and makeshift something?
How does one makeshift something?
I will let you use one reaction point to tear off a piece of cloth from any piece of your clothing or whatever, and use another one to administer it like a band-aid or like a suture, whatever you need realistically, and stop the bleeding and heal yourself.
Yeah, I'll do that.
However,
oh.
The healing itself. The healing itself is only going to be a D4 plus whatever bonus you have for your medical education.
I'll take it.
Okay. So you take two reaction points off.
Wait, two? You said one.
I said one to create the bandage and one to administer it, unless you want to use something else.
Can I just use my first aid kit?
Yes. Yeah, 100%. using the first aid kit will heal a d20 plus your medicine education.
Woo!
D20. Pew! But and then...
You are,
okay, what's the what?
You are using it.
Oh, I can't use it anymore.
No.
Oh.
And that may change in the future depending on if we want to discuss buying ones that have multiple uses.
Oh, so it's like a one-use kit?
Yep.
All right, fine. I'll use two reaction points.
Boo, hiss.
So you're going to create a bandage?
Yeah.
All right. Mitsurugi, right next to you, in a flash, you watch Tsukihi tear off a piece of her lower garment. You're still wearing very nice clothing, by the way. I don't think you're in your uniform.
Yeah,
and she rips it in a perfect, like, rectangular bandage. You watch her pull out a few pieces of pin and... like sew, or not sew, but close the bandage around her, and it staunches the bleeding as it kind of restricts the blood flow in her. So D4 plus, what's your medicine education bonus?
Four.
All right, so a D4 plus.
Wait,
four.
Sorry, I didn't mean that.
It's funny because that's actually the most you could have gotten on your regular roll.
I know. Wait, D4 plus four.
Correct.
All right, let's go.
Oh, okay, six.
Nice. So wait, do I heal myself? Do I
get
more HP?
Yeah, you heal six.
Nice. 26.
Chi.
Yay. Feel physically anxious.
She is looking at you. She has her eyelids starting to lift, but... you can't see any eyes inside. There's just a cold, pressure-filled gaze leaving her sockets. It's as though she has eyes and they are giving you a killer stare.
Mm-hmm. Gulp.
Where do you want to move?
I don't know. I'm scared. I don't want to attack her.
Mm-hmm.
I think. I don't know what to do.
That's so, okay.
Raising her failed, right?
We can still try.
I mean, I could try, but I don't know what
Hang on a second. I don't know if it's a good idea for you to try. She seems pretty PO'd at you.
No,
I thought she liked you.
I was gonna say,
did
Jordan,
she have a crush on me?
She is not PO'd at Chi. It's a more of an admiration, an envy.
Well, yeah. Whatever she's feeling towards Chi, I felt like it was gonna be
dangerous.
Negative for killing Chi. Oh,
okay. Yeah.
But I don't know. I mean, I think if you think you can work with that, then be my guest, you know?
See, this is, like, my worst scenario because I'm not good at, like, improv stuff like that.
You can just give me a social or, like, charisma.
All right, I'll do that. I'm not like Jordan where I can riz her up.
Apparently, I can't.
All right.
Give me...
I'll pull up my social.
Yeah, social...
I'm so sorry.
What do you want to convince her that you're interested in her? That you're
that find I'm not a threat?
So you want to try and act non-threatening?
I guess so. Like, I don't know. I want to know why she's like, she's looking at me like that.
Okay. Are you putting your sword away?
Yeah.
Okay. Give me...
Do I do my social still, or...?
Yeah, give me a social.
Okay. I, like, actually feel, like, physically anxious.
Whoa! All
right.
Okay, 22.
She approaches you and doesn't... Like, as she gets closer to you, your body feels colder and colder. You find yourself not in a fight or a flight, but a fawn moment. As she approaches you, your legs turn to jelly, and you fall to your knees, and she inspects you. Rather than attacking you, she still has this handkerchief out, this crimson stained handkerchief that has done so much damage to Mitsurugi and Tsukihi. Surely, if she wanted to, with a moment's flick of her wrist, she would obliterate your skull. But she stops, and she gets down, and she grabs you. She puts her pointer finger out in a curl, and her thumb to your chin, and she just continues to inspect your face. She looks you up and down. She has these eyes that move all around her hood, and moving it around your head, and grabbing your shoulders at one point to inspect you. She makes a kind of, like, content grunt to herself and pulls out this similar sheet to what she had done to Soften. And it's an extra large handkerchief that she's pulled out of almost nowhere, an unknown pocket. And suddenly everything goes completely dark as she wraps you. Are suddenly a little smaller, but you're now in a bag curled up.
Okay.
Mitsurugi, it's your turn.
No, it's not. No, it's not.
I had my hands over my eyes that entire time.
It is so not my turn.
It is actually your turn now.
It's Tsukihi's turn.
No,
I can heal.
You never did anything.
Hey, Grant, can you look at your DM?
Hold on. Oh, Raquel sent me a boo sound.
Please.
All right, Mitsurugi.
We sports reaction noises.
The bag she holds is a little handkerchief, like rolled into a bag. On it are designs that now fluctuate, turning into like an orange and pink peach, or like field of peaches with a like pastel pink base color.
Oh my god, does it reflect me?
Yes.
Can I talk to her?
She is inspecting this bag, spinning it around in her hands, but you have no idea if what you'll say she'll respond to, but you can try and yell something to her if you like.
Don't make her mad!
Hey, yo, I'm so good at making her mad. what?
Sorry, no, continue. It's after you're done that I'm gonna move us over.
I want to say, God. I can't. She doesn't want me like that.
Rory, are you on the owlbear?
What?
Are you on owlbear?
Yeah.
You fucking liar.
I'm literally on it right now. Are you kidding me?
It might
I'll
be.
Draw, I'll draw it right now. Ooh, wait. I'll put in a mount. Wait, fuck. You have to upload mounts? Damn it. Hold on. How do I draw?
Okay. Can I speak or are you talking to Rory now?
No, you're good.
Rory. I start crying. And TBD? I say
choked up Mitsurugi.
Stop.
He's
what?
I said choked up Mitsurugi.
Yeah. What did you do to her?
She doesn't seem to entertain what you said, want to answer your question is what I'm trying to get to, but instead looks over at you, realizing almost like she's like, oh right, you're here, and says, she was just so cute, I had to have her.
Sophie's fucking quivering from wherever I am.
What's up?
I said, and what about us?
She places a finger to her chin. Jesus Christ, sorry. I'm also trying to stop this from autoplaying. She puts a finger to her chin and taps it very lightly, almost like she's thinking for a moment, and suddenly is like, oh, you'll be able to see me when I'm done. Perfect. Since you love looking at me so much, you should enjoy the sight. And she pulls out from her sleeve, after putting the peach bag somewhere on her back or in her gown, and pulls out two very long handkerchiefs that you recognize as the ones that had captured Sofen and Chi.
Oh my fucking god.
She's preparing them for you, evidently.
You get a handkerchief, and you get a handkerchief.
I'm still, emotional. I'm still teary-eyed. And I say, please, we just want to know what we can do to stop your grieving.
That there's question
this,
catches...
piece.
Yeah.
There's this little piece right here that you can erase.
Yes.
Thank you.
Jordan... She almost kind of laughs at that proclamation of, like, stop my grief. Well, my grief is what brought me here.
And you think...
Good grief.
And you think it's okay to...
She stops
subject
you.
Subject all of us.
I grow tired of words, boy. You've too many of them, and too many of them have hurt my... very, very, very fragile soul today. And these have begun to anger me. And she is going to throw what is almost now weighted, her handkerchief, flying down the hallway towards one of you. You guys can either give me a finesse check to dodge or a reaction point.
Finesse.
I'm going to give a reaction
point. All right, go ahead. Jordan, give me your finesse check. Raquel, you can move up to 6 spaces around. Go for it.
Does that count diagonal?
Yes.
I got a 17.
Oh, Jordan.
I got a rock.
That's one of the highest ones I can get.
That's fair. You did do it. I'm just saying it's so close. Like, you're riding the fucking line here. You can move as well. You guys watch as this handkerchief flies down the hall, and as it lands on nothing, it falls flat. And suddenly, as if a gust of air has brought it up, which you know there is none, given there's no air down here, or at least no flowing air, it's returned back to her down the hall where you cannot see. From that, it is her turn. Still, she's going to use her movement, and she just starts going down the hall where she can hear it trembling.
Oh, no! Can you Rory. Not, Grant?
Die. Finally, Jesus Christ.
Chill, dog.
Let me out of this fucking shadow realm. I hate it here.
Rory, have you looked around on the map?
Are they on a different map?
Different part of the map.
I just gotta scroll a little bit.
It's on the marker. Damn it.
Oh my god.
Rory.
Oh, you don't look like in a fun place.
I know. You alright, girl?
Is it down here? Oh, god. I'm so small. Okay, I'm like really zoomed out.
You.
Okay.
Awaken inside a black void. And as you push any level of strength into your hands outward, you find a bag unfolding over top of you. Nearby you are several human corpses and 2 freshly dropped dead bodies.
Are they stinky?
They reek.
Not as stinky as you.
Necrosis and like maggots.
I lick my lips.
Okay.
I start chewing my way through the bag.
You're already out of the bag.
I am. I guess this cat's out of the bag.
You stand up to no applause.
Went a single tear as I shake the dead body hand.
You stand up to booze. The corpses are killing you.
I'm lost in the sauce, to be completely honest with you.
okay.
What's around me?
Corpses. There's besides a few planks, a window, and then a door that is closed.
What's through the window?
You reach up, you grab the windowsill, and pull yourself up to the ceiling height. And outside, you can see you are in a shed a little far ways out of the like center of town, in the area that you guys had walked around or at least near to bury the dead body.
Oh, sorry about Thea also.
You're okay.
Never say sorry to her.
We're getting her used to Zeke's smell. So she's like screaming and hissing.
All right, Rory.
I go up the windowsill, and what happens?
You go up the windowsill, and... Oh, hold on. Outside the windowsill, you can see that you were in the area that you had traveled to just nights before, where you had buried a dead body. It's just the outskirts of town, far enough that no one really comes to see or look. There's a little bit of forestry, but just, like, hedging and small mounds. You are in a shed that has a viewpoint into the city, or at least you can see toward the city. You're a mile's walk, a few minutes walk back. Undetermined location.
Interesting. Yes, please. Thank you.
You want to give me a little... You want to investigate the...
yeah.
Area?
Well, like, the dead bodies around me, see if I recognize any of them. Okay. I know, like, two were fresh.
Give me a perception check.
Where is my investigation?
Investigation for finding out where you are, honestly.
Sure.
And but perception for noticing the bodies.
All right, 17 on investigation. And oh my god, I hate it when cats cry. It fills me with grief, guilt, and dread.
With the investigation check, you've determined that you're a mile and a half out from the city, just beyond the theatrical the theatrical district. You can see the lights shining, or at least where the lights would be shining. You could recognize it from here and make your way back easy. And you can also see the path that leads out towards the Sensoji Temple and beyond. There is almost no people around, and from what it looks like around you, this shed seems to be kind of concealed.
That's interesting. So, it was here the whole fucking time. Holy dick. I want to try the door now. I want to get out of here.
The door appears to be locked, chained in the front.
I fucking break it. Are you kidding me?
Give me a force check.
I'm a demon slayer. That is my whole gig.
Oh, yeah. How do you bust the door down? How do you bust down?
I
bust it.
Yeah, I hip check it with my, but like it's all ass, like it just kind of bounces off my butt cheeks.
Okay, you hear an explosion of the hinges ripping free and the door flying in a perfect, like it doesn't bend with wind resistance. It's just flying cartoonishly across the way. You realize the door was a little disguised, but not very well, and you are free. Outside, you can hear a clucking, very similar to one you've heard many a times. It sounds like searching.
And I'm gonna stretch, and I'm gonna be like, Joe.
Suddenly, the clucking grows louder and louder until suddenly it's just in front of you as a chicken leaps from the brush into your arms. So onto your chest with his claws grabbing your uniform for some kind of stability. He's just kind of standing on you now.
All right. Hey, bucko. So here's the thing. Crisis mode.
Yeah.
I need you to go. Wait. We dropped from a plane. Fuck. Wait, no, they can fly and travel. Yeah.
Yeah.
What? God, what's his name? What's his name? Just like Soften, I don't remember name.
On the mission?
I need you to go get the Hashira. The guy that sent us on this mission.
You can.
He's blue.
Could you? Are you just gonna ask him for some kind of help?
I mean, I don't have anything to like write a note.
That's fair. He has stuff on him.
He has. Dude, my chicken is strapped. What the hell?
Your chicken has a
calligrapher.
He has a little backpack with a pencil and notepad in it.
Aww.
Does he have like? Does he have like? I don't know, like a loaded gun?
No. That would be funny to show, though.
That would be helpful.
It would be, but he doesn't.
He keeps that thing on him.
I'm gonna send him a note that says,
He's like, fuck, I also can't write.
No. My name's Jared. I'm 19, and I never learned how to fucking read. Found the grieving moon. Way stronger than we thought. Probably need some help. Maybe
definitely
engage.
Need some help.
Maybe engage? Question mark.
Mm-hmm.
And yeah.
All right.
That's good.
Do you send him out?
Yes.
He fucking bolts as soon as you drop him. He disappears into the brush before what you can see, like, damn, the tall grass moving around him like velociraptors in fucking Jurassic Park. Ah. He guns his way towards some direction that you assume he knows is good. You are left alone now near this shed.
And I... Yeah, well,
would
fuck,
you like to
I'm gonna
head back?
Friend.
What's up?
I'm gonna go help my friends.
All right.
I have a plan.
Yeah.
At least one of us does.
Soften. It's gonna take you how many minutes? What's your speed?
At full sprint.
Full sprint.
Full sprint.
Okay.
Yeah. We'll send. Let's go, baby.
Give me a speed check.
Ciao.
We're gonna say 15 rounds.
Oh,
minus
Bob
8.
Saget.
So just 7 rounds, Jordan. Can you survive for a minute and can you survive
what?
For 40 almost 40 seconds 42
Me?
Seconds yeah, can you survive for 42 seconds, guys?
Why not?
7 rounds back over inside for 7 rounds
of combat.
You heard me.
All
right, back.
You're crazy.
Oh my god, it won't let me move. Back good. Inside.
Hey-o.
Jordan? No, that's not how it works. Raquel. No, Raquel.
Let her do what she wants.
No more messing. So she can move 50 feet in her turn.
Oh,
Starting
so
now,
silly.
You guys have 7
break.
Rounds until Soften arrives.
I like that this is not a dig against Soften, but I like that we're like, yeah, we'll survive when Soften gets here. Like, it's still a move.
Well, no, you don't know that Soften's gonna get here.
Right. it's not our turn, though, is it? Or did she use
no,
her turn to move?
She used her turn to move. It's your turn, Sam.
Well, not
this
my turn.
So awesome and fun.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm having so much awesome fun.
Yeah, what happened with Chi? Where's Chi?
I'm so scared that Grant just killed me.
No. It is Tsukihi's turn.
Okay, good. I'm going to the bathroom.
You don't have that much time, Jordan.
I'm well, still listening. World. I'm just muting
oh, okay,
myself.
Okay, 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 okay. Raquel.
How do you get cats acclimated to each other? Guilt free.
You pray. Comment down below.
Raquel shuts down.
Raquel?
Did you say the Microsoft startup sound?
It's, yeah. Is she
uh-oh.
Still with us?
We lost. Oh.
We broke Raquel.
Are you back?
Hello.
Yeah, it's
oh,
your
okay.
turn, Raquel.
Yippee! Alright, guys. Good night!
No!
Well, I kind of wanted to discuss with Mitsurugi what we were gonna do.
Well,
you can tell me what you were thinking. You can talk. I'm just muted right now. All right.
Go piss, girl.
So what do you want to do, girly pop? I love the silence. So, Jordan, like, do you want to, like, run, or do you want to try to save these people? I feel like your answer is going to want to be save these people.
Sorry, I'm saving you from my bathroom noises. It kind of is saving the people.
All right, see. Excuse me, with 70 rounds?
No, you want less rounds, Raquel.
Why? Also, not to mention, she has chi.
As the rounds go down...
Yeah, but also...
The soften will arrive.
Okay. How many spaces can we move per...
You guys can move six round. Spaces, or 30 feet. So you can go... Like...
Let's make some noise. Let's cause a distraction. Let's get her attention.
Yeah, because it's like, there's no way we're going to catch up to her.
You guys can do that dance number we were practicing.
Oh my god, yeah.
What dance number?
And I don't mind if the world
is You guys pull the trolls fucking...
Yeah. Just trying to take you to a better place. Thank you.
Okay, there's no way we could catch up to her, because it's like, we move 6, she's gonna move fucking 50.
You move 6, she moves 10.
Still. Hold on, let me get this ruler. So, it's 30, so that's 1. 2.
Well, hold on, Raquel. You're missing squares. Because you have to go in order. So you'd get here, and you'd move 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and then keep moving.
Like Monopoly.
Yeah.
It's like we're not getting to her. She's too far. All right. How should we yell a personal insult to make her angry? I think she's already angry. Hint.
Your ass idea. Is flat.
Paint a rock like a cute dog as a decoy.
Whoa, that's pretty smart.
Soften moment.
Or we're talented at, like, things.
Raquel, you have 42 seconds total. What do you think Tsukihi would start by doing? Do you think she's chasing after her at first?
I feel like she's, like, about to, then she's like, I can't catch up to her.
You can still try. You can use breathing techniques to try and move even farther.
Okay, let's see. Hold on, let me see what I got.
If you move to your fullest movement, and then you use a breathing technique, you can move that amount of distance.
I have a question, DM man.
Yeah.
Is 7 rounds like I am going to be moving 7 times, or is one person going 1 round?
Everybody is moving.
7 times?
Yeah.
Holy shit.
So you guys better figure it the fuck out.
Can I phone a friend?
No.
Fuck, Grant.
Raquel, you gotta do something soon. Or I'm gonna kill you.
Okay, fine. I'm gonna move my 6 spaces, and I'm gonna try to use breathing.
Alright. Moving to closer move. To her. So 1, 2,
I guess so.
3, 4, 5, 6.
Sure. Wow. Oh, back where I was before.
Yeah.
And then wait, each block is how much?
5 feet.
Jordan, I'm literally not going to go anywhere.
Jordan, if you want, you can also move since you guys.
Can I can I throw Jordan further?
Yeah, absolutely.
Oh my god, we're gonna play leapfrog.
Hold on, right, hold on. So are you gonna stay there, Raquel?
Huh?
Or where are you gonna end your turn?
I'm gonna pick up Jordan.
You're gonna pick up Jordan?
Yeah, and I'm gonna move 6 feet.
And you're gonna throw her or throw him?
No, I'm gonna move 6 and then throw.
Okay.
Can I do that?
Jordan, are you okay with that?
Sure.
All right, because you're not gonna be able to. Actually.
Not gonna be able to what?
I think I'd actually allow that. Yeah.
What?
If you wanna move after you fall, like land.
Okay.
Do you want me to roll like a?
Give me. You know what, Jordan? Give me finesse, Raquel. Give me force.
Do I add raw power?
No, you're force. So you're total force. You're adding your force, which is already better than which is already better.
Nice.
Already, your force should be better than your raw power. Okay.
21. 21.
You know what? And you know what? Raquel,
can I please roll again?
I'll let you throw him half as far. So like, I'll let you throw him 15 feet. But Jordan, you land it like perfectly. Like you were a little shaky on the liftoff, but you fucking land it like a queen.
Thank you.
That was so painful.
Yeah. You know when you throw someone but you lose a little bit of the balance as you're throwing them and it throws off how much or how far it goes?
Yeah.
That's essentially, you just wobbled his foot a little bit as he was kicking off you. Jordan? Right.
Well, at least we're further than when we were.
Correct.
Before.
Jordan, you can move your 6 spaces and also any other bonus movement from breathing forms if you have them. Okay.
1, 2, 3.
Is you not gonna throw me?
5, 6. I'm gonna backtrack to throw you.
Leapfrog.
Can I see her from where I am right now?
You watch her veil kind of pass by the corner just as you make it to the hallway.
Can I shoot her veil?
Yeah, give me your. I believe it's Dex plus accuracy.
Could shoot it?
Yes.
Unless
you have anything that lets you automatically hit. Oh no, sorry. It is.
Oh. Where's my other gun?
You have 2.
I have a rifle and I thought I had a pistol.
You do.
I have a pistol.
You might still.
I don't know.
You didn't give it to someone, did you?
Wait, did I?
I don't know.
I don't think so.
Jordan, give me Dex or finesse. Sorry.
Oh god, Alfredo's running around. Dude,
there he goes.
And you add your accuracy to damage. I was off the shits.
Oh yes. I do. What am I doing, finesse?
Finesse to see if you hit her.
Right. And we'll do this.
Raquel, prepare your next move.
I'll be back.
No!
Son of a bitch!
Jordan, you hit the wall behind her and watch her disappear into the next room.
She isn't concerned about that?
No.
Does he turn around?
Jesus!
Oh, Grant!
Let me make sure I'm going 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
How come you can move diagonally?
8, 9, 10. You guys can.
Oh, we can't. It's just like that there were walls in the way.
Oh. Well, she's not doing that.
I have Alfredo on my shoulder now.
Yeah.
She's so antsy.
Post picture of Alfredo. All right. Raquel. Who's dead?
What's in?
No, sorry.
Who's dead?
Nobody's
dead. What's in between this?
It's pure rock.
Oh, can I change this to 6 rounds?
Yes. She goes over to these people, and you can hear screaming from down the hall, Mitsurugi.
Oh my god.
Girl! It's not my turn!
Raquel, it's your turn.
Oh, sorry, I'm still on
every
the
time. You guys can also do movement if you'd like. Like
what
just
movement?
Just do movement, and we can count down the rounds. You guys are just running for this round if you don't have anything. If you can't do anything like an attack, if you just move, we can count that to the next round.
All right.
Oops.
There's one round.
Jordan?
Hang on, sorry. It's gonna take away one of my bullets. 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Alright.
Wait, no, not alright.
Are you gonna do something?
I'm not done, stop moving here.
Okay.
Feels like New Year's is what someone said.
The worst New Year's.
Oh, she doesn't even want to talk to me anymore.
She doesn't even describe
herself as a woman.
So true.
Let your hair down.
I literally don't know what will get her attention. Hey, ugly!
Do you actually say that to her?
Yeah.
Oh my god.
Jordan.
No!
There goes your head.
Jordan,
attention.
So that's your turn.
Cool.
Jordan, that was crazy.
You hear screaming, and it all comes to a halt and falls to, like, pure silence. She turns back with four bags, or four small handkerchief-wrapped bags. Let me just... and
already gone,
like, has four of them in one hand and is now turned to you. Her eyes are open and they are empty and they emanate this killer aura. Where are you? The wall dividing you guys, this thing right here, you see it snaps off in a whip crack. All of a sudden, shattered stone debris hits you in the face. And her second attack, I should say you're still bleeding, by the way.
So
you're not taking damage, but you're going to have disadvantage on attacks if you try and attack her like this.
Okay.
Jordan, can you give me a finesse check or reaction point?
I can give you a finesse check.
Okay. You're going to take disadvantage on this finesse check.
Why?
Because you are literally profusely bleeding. Your chest is spewing blood.
I need a reaction point for this one.
Do you need a reaction? Okay, yeah. Your heart beats
good
from
choice,
her.
Good choice.
You can see this crimson stained handkerchief is starting to turn black, and as soon as it touches the stone behind you, a face forms into the stone and shapes like a weeping, crying woman. She just begins moving towards you now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
She took all the people in the handkerchiefs?
Yep. In an instant, Jordan, she appears in front of you.
Oh my god.
Like a flash. Her face... Now blackened by the lack of light touching it, and all along her hood you can see glowing red eyes.
Oh no, she's hot.
Jordan?
Girly Pop, who hurt you?
Oh, Girly Pop.
Jody.
It's not my turn.
It's Raquel's turn, you're right. Raquel. The screaming has stopped. And you hear two very distinct whip cracks that shatter stone down the hall.
Fun.
What does Sukihi want to do?
How far do I have to move just to see things?
10 feet. You can see Mitsurugi. Or Jordan, you didn't move with your reaction point very far, but you didn't. When you use a reaction, you can move your six spaces when you're dodging an attack.
I don't think it really matters right now.
Well, go back.
What does it matter? She's just gonna chase me. Maybe this is better because I'm closer to her.
Well, at least give yourself some space. Nice.
Alright. Raquel, you need to move 10 feet to see Mitsurugi down the hall.
Mm-hmm.
He's still bleeding. And very labored breathing.
Can I toss him the blood, demon blood syringe?
Absolutely.
Oh shit.
Yo.
You better fucking catch it.
You don't need to roll for it. You just toss it to him.
Yeah, man.
Jordan, Mitsurugi reaches his hand up. How does he catch it? Is it like a not looking catch? Is it a
Does Tsukihi say anything to me before she throws it?
Of course. Here's a syringe. Throws a needle first. No. Imagine like just like, chucks it at you and it just stabs you. No,
Raquel.
He is not taking his eyes off the grieving moon then. He's catching it without looking.
Jordan, Raquel, that was really cool. You can both add a reaction point back.
Thank you.
Now that things are shaking, Jordan, it's your turn.
Yeah.
All right. I break the syringe. No, I'm kidding. honestly, can I have a refresher on what the syringe does? Because I've never had one, so I haven't written down what it does.
Absolutely. Demon blood syringe. A syringe filled with cured demon blood that can be used to instantly heal broken bones, lacerations, and other grievous wounds. However, it comes with a side effect. It can only be used 3 times before causing hysterical damage like heart attacks or seizures. It requires a medicine check to use and takes a full turn to administer, but it fully heals you from all damage.
Wait, Grant, does each syringe only have one use?
Yes. This is incredibly hard stuff to come by, so it doesn't come. It also doesn't need a lot to be used, so it comes in very small syringes. Raquel, did you get a syringe, or did you get a... You got a syringe. Okay, never mind. I was thinking...
Yeah, I usually ask for one every time I have the chance. That's true.
All right, Jordan. You've caught this. Do you want to use it?
I probably should.
I think I should.
You're like, actually, I'm scared of needles. Can you do it for me while I don't look?
Unless, would anything cool happen if I tried to stab her with it?
Well, that's assuming that you could stab her with it.
Let's assume that I could.
Nobody's ever done it. Mainly because it's so useful.
You should probably stop yourself from fucking bleeding.
Yeah.
Can't really stab her if you're dead.
So true, Bessie. Hang on, I'm just... how do we do that? Okay. yeah, sure. I'll stick that fucker in me.
All right. Jordan, give me a medicine check.
Hey.
Oh, yeah, let's baby. Go.
Oh, yeah.
Jordan, Mitsurugi takes the syringe, almost immediately finds a vein and injects it. Does take his turn, but he can still move. Immediately, his chest wound seals itself back up, and he feels no scarring, nothing take place. It is 100% healed, and even any of the internal damage he had suffered has now been kind of reset. Feels good as new.
Let him
do I recover all my HP or no?
All your HP. Now it's her turn. So first, do your movement.
I guess I'll meet up with Tsukihi.
Hey, girl.
Hey, girly.
And that's another round down, right? Yippee!
All
right. Yay! She could stay
one,
there!
One, two, three.
Can she not?
You guys...
Yeah, tell her to slow down.
You guys have 24 seconds.
24 seconds?
She has three attacks. She's going to hit Mitsurugi twice and you once. Do either of you want to use reaction points?
That's so mean.
Jordan, can you called her ugly.
In my defense, I thought it was going to stop her before she hurt the innocents.
Can I, like, scream and ask, like, girl, who hurt you? Like, what's the deal?
She gives you back, like, a who hasn't, and immediately starts throwing out handkerchief whips.
All I did was talk. I didn't move. Let me move.
Jordan, how many reaction points are you using? One or two?
One.
All right, and then give me a finesse check to dodge. Raquel, reaction point or finesse check?
I'm gonna do a reaction point. I'm running out.
Jordan!
That was so close to a 20. That was so close to a 20.
Jordan, you are taking a D10 plus 3.
Oh my god.
Kill yourself?
I would say you, but you're already killing yourself.
Stop!
Oh my god! Raquel, yeah, move however far you need to. Mitsurugi, you dodge the first whip, and immediately the second one tears into your leg.
Oh my fucking god.
Dude, I just healed side. You.
Jordan, this cut goes down your left waist into your left thigh. It is.
So there's nothing left in that demon syringe, right?
Nothing.
That's true.
Because you just healed. That's infuriating.
Go ahead and move your reaction spaces, Joe.
Yeah.
Oh my god. Alfredo's on my head right now.
Yeah.
Oh my god! He just jumped off onto my desk!
Oh my god.
Am I moving? Whose turn is it?
Yeah.
Oh my god,
you,
girl.
Because you did a reaction point.
Oh, my reaction.
You get to move, but then it's Chi. Or no, not Chi. It's Tsukihi. Chi wishes.
Holy crap.
Hey. Yeah, right.
It's so true.
Sorry, guys.
You're good.
I'm so scared.
All right.
I'm so fucking scared right now.
Raquel, Jordan, what do you want to do?
I know. We have to do something. We can't just keep running and using reaction points.
Why not?
I know we're waiting the rounds, but there has to be something else we can do to help.
So what are we doing?
Do you have any, like, defense moves?
Let me see. Let me see.
I think Mitsu just likes the thrill of a near death.
Honestly?
It's an acquired taste.
Not really.
Oh boy. Now, all those fucking moves, none of them are defense.
What about you?
I have defense moves!
Okay.
Can we try to get some information out of her? Can we, like, still try to talk to her? Or is it just not gonna go anywhere?
You can do whatever you want, Raquel.
Are you mad at us?
No.
That sounded like you were mad at us, girl. Are you mad at us?
That's the right kind of
what do you? All right. Take your movement now, and then you guys can tell me what you're going to use your action for. Which way are you moving?
What if we fake fight? What if we get into an argument with each other about how beautiful she is?
I'm not
necessarily disagreeing with the proposition. I'm just trying to think of a way that it would actually work in our favor.
Like, as we continue to move, didn't mean to move that, we just have an argument with each other about how beautiful she is. I'll be like, you stupid for calling her ugly. I'll be like, she's so beautiful. Why can't you see that? I don't fucking know.
Pretty much said she was done with me, so I don't think I can do anything.
Yeah, but what if I drag you down and be like, yeah, I'll take care of him. Like, you don't want his blood on your hands.
Yeah, if you want to seem like a hero.
Yeah.
Alright. You guys,
already,
give me...
I'm already pretty down and out. I'm bleeding out again.
Move your movement and then give me a performance or deception. I would say performance, please. So
I don't have anything for performance.
That sounds like a you problem.
Do I do plus social? Do I do...
Nope. No social. Just performance right. Flat.
We're going wrong.
Right. Do you want to move?
Because I got a nat 20 on my riz.
2, 3, 4.
Jordan,
five.
You know what? I'll give you a plus one since you did get a nat 20.
Thank you.
All right.
Yay!
Thank you.
All right. We'll have to be super loud so she could hear us from afar away.
I got a 16.
All right,
one,
two,
all
right,
three, here we go.
5, 6, 7.
Oh, it was so close to a 19.
She is going to use a reaction, two reactions, three reactions, and then four.
She's using reactions?
She's gonna do what?
She's using four reaction points, and she is going to...
Do what?
Oh, God. Sorry. She is going to hit you with an attack. Or at least Mitsurugi, who is in her sight line.
Can I do a defense?
I was gonna say, actually, you're out of line of sight, so Mitsurugi's the only one in line of sight. And she's using two reaction points. And suddenly, Mitsurugi is curled up into a cloth ball. All along this very nicely, like, baby blue, tinged with red, patterned ball, bag is little sake cups and drinks with, like, hair clips and such.
What if I touch? What happens if I touch it? What happens if I touch it?
That's rough.
What do you mean rough? That's what if I try to pull it off of him?
Yeah, you can. You can touch him. Go ahead.
No, tell me what happens.
You have to put your hand on it first.
Can I put my pinky finger on it?
Yeah, you touch it with your pinky finger, and it unwraps itself.
Ah, nice.
And
is it really?
Yeah. You, Jordan, you're back on the floor.
Oh no!
Wait! Can I pick him up and toss him behind me?
He's not like knocked out, or he was. I
but
guess,
like,
Jordan,
can
you
I,
are
like, pull
you are
him up to your feet.
Yeah, you stand him up. Jordan, you were about to lose consciousness, and now it's like when you almost fall asleep and you catch yourself and you wake up. That's the vibe essentially of how this feels.
Epic.
You are brought to your feet by Tsukihi. Tsukihi, it's your turn. But you can both move if you want.
Okay, we just learned something new. Did the performance not work and that's why she did that?
No, she didn't even get to see the performance. She's just really tired of chasing you guys.
I think she should leave then.
Yeah, just leave.
I think she should stop, yeah.
I guess we'll keep moving.
Just go ahead and move.
What's that gray thing?
I think that right was there? Something that we had left over. That's not...
someone smashed into the wall or something.
All right. Mitsu, do you want to move?
Oh, sorry.
What? Can I see... Like, can I see the bag that she is in on her person?
Yeah.
Okay, I would like to... Oh my god, oops, sorry. I would like to,
Your pants.
Try someone to... said,
just say JK, this is my prank channel.
I was just kidding, it's a prank!
I kind of thought of something, maybe.
Wait, hold on. Jordan has tried to say something, like, three times, and we've interrupted.
No, I want to hear what Raquel is thinking.
Okay.
So, wait, the bag that she is in was very similar to the bag that Mitsurugi was just in, right?
Yes. They are small, clearly, like, hand-wrapped bags that take on personalities based on who's inside them, or at least art around them.
And it's just on her.
They're hanging on the, like, inside of her kimono, but you can
inside?
See...
Inside?
Like, she's holding some of them, and some of them are strapped to her side.
Can I undo my move?
To put Mitsurugi back in the thing?
No, like, my move of running.
Oh, yeah. Undo your movement, sure.
So what if you run forward, I run up, you get her attention... I sneak up behind her and touch the bag that she's in to release Chi.
Yeah, why not use myself as bait again? I love doing that.
Well, we could get, like, now we know we could get you out of the bag.
Thank you so much. That's only helpful if she decides she doesn't want to kill me.
But well, sure, we'll get you out.
I'll be
we'll
bait.
Get you out.
Thank you. Wilson,
Hugs and kisses, Illy.
I have a question.
What did you want to do?
Was Sothin... What happened to Sothin? I thought that he was also pulled in a handkerchief.
She threw him backward, like, out the door.
Oh, shit.
So she had someone take him.
Okay, cool. Sweet.
Sothin was delivered.
Cool.
All right, so what are you guys going... What is the plan?
Well, if you want me to be the bait, go ahead, but she's going to want to go after you.
Right. No, that's cool and fine. I'm going to... go up to her.
Wait, go up?
Like, run up
Didn't
to
you
her?
Just say that I should...
No. You what? Come here... I go here.
Oh, okay.
Here.
Okay.
We need an opening!
So let's move.
Okay.
1, 2, 3, 4. Oh, wait, I can move that. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Wait.
Well, make sure you're still seen.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. She is going to use 4 reaction points, and both of you are turned to small bags. So Chihis takes on a dark maroon flame.
What the fuck is this reaction point turning into bats?
Bags. You are both turned into bags. She's thrown her long wrapping handkerchief. You can hear her saying it out loud. She calls it hand cage. Yeah, very poorly.
I'm hiding. She did not know I was in this corner.
She has eyes all around her head, Raquel.
Oh, bitch, it's dark in here.
can we do an undo and I can do what I was going to do?
No.
Yeah, can we redo?
No.
Hold on.
All right, go ahead, Grant.
She throws both of these out here and you both find yourself suddenly encased in darkness. You disappear for the moment, and suddenly everything falls
black. Boo!
Game over.
Boo.
Hold on.
Okay. 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 I'm waiting.
We'll hold our boo.
Fucking hate this.
Rory.
Yeah.
As you arrive at the cinema.
Hold up.
Yes.
I'm making some very, very quick stops on the way. Like, exchanges that are like, I see the product, I grab it, and the money's on the counter as I'm leaving.
Okay. Tell me what it is.
And I'm stopping by the local Cumbies and grabbing a gallon of gas.
Okay. Okay. So, yeah, facts.
Gas? Can I actually grab gas?
Oh, you actually want to buy gasoline?
Yes, like propane, yes. Gasoline.
Yes, something. You buy a gallon of gasoline and it fills up the last slot in your backpack. You can remove any of the other three items in your backpack if you would like.
Where's my backpack? Backpack. I eat the can of food.
Okay. You regain a certain amount of stamina. Let me check how much. You gain +5 bonus stamina.
Oh, shit. That's hot and dangerous. Wait, so then, I +5 to my adjusted or to like whatever I have right now?
Whatever you have right now, you just have 5 temporary stamina that depletes before any of your normal stamina will deplete.
Oh, that's tight. Well, my total's 39 and I'm at 34, so I'm just back up to 39.
Baller. Where else do you want to stop?
I have matches, right?
No. But you do have something else.
But I can...
No, you can do it with your sword, too.
Okay, yeah. All right, so we're fine. There we go.
Soften, as you arrive at the theater, there are several...
Wait.
What's up?
Okay, yes. No, we're good. Okay, while I'm running, can I, like, start dipping, like... Or, like, start, like, just pouring the gasoline all over the parachute?
Sure.
Yes.
Give me a dexterity check, but sure. Yes. As you arrive at the theater, there are several different men working outside that are keeping guests from going inside. Specifically, these people are keeping what appears to be like in covert Kakushi or Demon Slayers. You can tell by some of them having Demon Slayer estate stuff on. Some of them are press. Some of them are policemen. And others are just like very clearly fake citizens, like people dressed up to pretend to be citizens to act in some kind of covert espionage. And as you slip by some unknown reason, for 16, I guess, you spot over in the lobby while some guests are moving around two familiar faces. I don't actually know if you've met all three of them. But three eyes immediately turn and lock on you as you enter the room. Can you give me a perception check on which one you identify
first?
Three
eyes?
Three sets of eyes. Three sets of eyes. My bad.
Like someone's missing an eye.
Either someone has crazy anatomy or this dude lost an eye.
Yeah.
Or it could be Cyclops.
And I'm opening this part up right here just to signify who, but...
Oh yeah, three individual Cyclops. That's right.
Shut up. Give me a d20. With your perception.
Just a... Oh. Wow. Okay.
Oh, awesome. You immediately recognize... the pair of closed eyes that have turned your way that are appearing, they appear to be napping. Katsuo, sleeping with sword very unkemptly tucked up his like pant leg, keeping his leg weirdly straight.
That's
he never really got down to practicing keeping that thing hidden. He goes right back to bed as soon as he sees you. The second set that you seem to notice is a very brightly blonde man staring at you from across the way, a little scared, nervous even, that you've arrived. And he waves you down very nervously, and it's like, over here! Followed by a second set of eyes, or the third set of eyes, just next to him as they were in conversation. Pissed off as he's like, oh, brother. Hanabi.
Can we get one of these bitches that I like?
No.
Do not like any of them?
Katsuo is like kind of my little boy. But he's my little boy.
Yeah. Do I okay. I do remember Atsuhiko. Atsuhiko, sorry.
Not I was gonna say not enough to remember his name apparently.
But I do not remember the others.
Oh my god, Hanabi
or Katsuo?
He was the one helping us with the time demon.
Yeah, Mitsu's always beating
Yeah, he was mean to me. He bullied me.
He stole the kill.
How old is he? Yeah, he's... Oh, no, he's not... Is he the one who only fights when they're, like, about to die?
He does the final...
Yeah, he's a last hitter. He's a finisher.
Oh, I forgot. Okay, so he sucks. Like, he can't kill anything. He can't fight anything, but he can kill. He can only kill.
Yeah.
Pretty much.
He's not gonna kill. Like, he's not gonna fight until he gets. Like, he knows he could get the final blow.
Yeah. And so I see them.
Yeah.
But I'm running. Like, I'm all business, baby. Let's fucking go.
They immediately charge after you. It's like, whoa, 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 hey, hey, hey! Atsuhiko immediately begins tying something over his eyes as Hanabi smacks him over the head. Katsuo, in like a sleepwalking run with a little snot bubble still like flowing in the wind, runs after you guys, his arms at his side. You guys enter into the broom closet, and immediately Atsuhiko makes a sudden pose and slices at the ground for a piece of wood to like fall into the stairwell. You guys are now able to enter as Hanabi stops hitting Atsuhiko for tying his blindfold and is like, all right, nice one, I guess. Fuck, let's just keep moving. He turns to Soph and is like, all right, Mr. Confidence, lead the way.
And I'm going. All right. We gone.
Let me... Katsuo, okay, so they are going to follow you in a trail. Treat them kind of like your own little party. I'm gonna...
Damn, replaced.
I'm gonna attach them to you for a sec. Alright. Where do you want to move, Saufin?
I'm going straight to like where I last saw her.
All right, that's just in the doorway.
Here, yep, which is here. So then I'm going to really quickly slap the walls.
All right. I believe it is like a sudden opening of your third eye as you examine the area surrounding you. I know you've inspected these halls before. It's become a little easier now with your perception to scan over and see if anything has changed, which nothing has. Where do you want to move next?
Okay, and so I'm going to point out, well, we went down into like the big area, right? I don't quite remember if we
did. I don't know exactly what you mean, but sure.
Down from where Katsuo is.
Yeah, we went here.
I would like to go... I'm going to explain to them. Further in front of us, down the hall, is a jail cell. It is where they keep a lot of the people that the demon... I'm assuming that the demon is consuming. There might still be more prisoners. We should probably go save them at some point. And then...
Hanabi, like, grabs you full palm by the mouth. And it's just like, God, shut the fuck up for a moment. Calm yourself and use articulate wording. Say it as simply as possible. We have not the time for you to explain this in some crass method of... Fuck, whatever you speak. I'm going to let you go, and you're going to use very precise choice of wording to inform us, me, my fellow compatriots, as... And he turns to them, simple-minded as they may be. And you hear Katsuo like, hey! And Katsuhiko's like, no, he's right. what is going on down here, and what are we here for? And he lets go of your mouth, taking out a small handkerchief to wipe his hand with.
Dude, I hate that bitch.
I'll go really close to him, and I'm like, so all my friends are gonna fucking die? I'm going. If you read the note, you would know. Follow me. And we go.
As you move, he's like, I read the note. They both kind of turn to Hanabi and like, as he's like, shut up. We read no note. We were simply given instruction by the Hashira attending. He says that and further explains that there will be a Hashira here in the next 5 minutes. We were just sent to scan the area out and make sure that everything was prepared. We're not supposed to be and he just like is stop moving. As Atsuhiko and Katsuo continue to move, as you walk into the prison cell area, I will say you can stop at the front. You notice that in the hall there are hanging 6 bags. All of these small bags are similar to what you remember falling out of, and all having various designs, very simple ones. Along with,
oh my god, where the fuck am I?
Very complex.
Yeah.
Soften, you can recognize Tsuki and Mitsurugi's by the texture and everything going on.
Mine has a ton of silhouettes of people doing a death drop.
It's like one of those whatever it's called, it starts with a Z. When you spin it, it looks like you animated death dropping.
Yeah,
I'll be right back.
All right, Katsuo. Atsuhiko and Hanabi all push past you as, like, this room comes into view. Katsuo reaches up, and he can't quite touch them from how small he is. And he's like, they're beautiful. He's like, they're beautiful. Whoever made them put a lot of effort. Atsuhiko then, like, grabs him by the lower waist and puts him up onto his shoulder where Katsuo can now, like, at least touch the bottoms of these bags. And as soon as he touches the bottom of it, this pair of siblings falls out, and Katsuo's like, oh shit! Suddenly, Katsuo is on the ground, and Atsuhiko has caught both of the children that have fallen.
Does he not recognize his father's coloring?
Atsuhiko is going to disappear for a moment, but he's like, whoop, you've gotta go! And dashes suddenly into a poof of flame. And is gone for the next 60 seconds or less.
60 seconds.
Katsuo turns to Hanabi, and which turns to Soften, and they all kind of, the two of them are like, hey, should we let the rest of them out?
Yes.
Perfect. I was thinking the same.
Like Wheel of Fortune,
as we're freeing them, I'm going to be explaining like how, like she works basically. Mm.
You explain how this is the Graving Moon, or at least what you believe is a moon, and both of them look a little startled, a little scared, but not in a like we're gonna leave sense. More in a like this is gonna be challenging sense. The few other people that are released are with Hanabi and Katsuo returned to the front area, stating that they'll be back.
The stream is offline.
Oh, yeah, it's attempting to reconnect.
Oh. That's so odd.
I know.
Oh.
Oh, there we go.
Yeah.
We're back.
That's all so right. Weird.
So now, with the civilians taken out, what would you guys like to do?
Where did everyone get released?
Yeah, you guys have been released.
I do a death drop. Coming out of my bag.
Yeah.
Can I? I give Safin a hug.
Oh.
And I say, and I pull away from him, and I say, I have literally never been as happy to see you as I am right now.
Do you know where the moon is?
No. I was a little busy being trapped in her handkerchief.
Well, I guess if you didn't run into her already, it's either straight ahead this way, or I guess to and the right.
I slap the ground real quick. I'm like, guys, where's Chi?
And that's why we have to find her.
All right. As this discussion is going on, the three return. Hanabi is first, followed by Katsuo, and then Atsuhiko. Hanabi, displeased to see the other three. Shut up. Hanabi seems quite...
She trained me!
Oh, you're talking about... I thought you were talking about Katsu. I thought you were saying you knew Miku.
Katsu named Miku?
No.
I also know her.
I was gonna say... Atsuhiko is also like, Tsuki! And he hugs her. He squeezes her very tightly. And
she squeezes back just as tightly.
All right, force check.
Force check. Who has the stronger hug?
For real.
Breaks bones.
He got an 11.
Oh, I'm doing. Is it plus?
Plus force.
Okay. I need everyone to know. There's a spider in my room right now, and I'm so afraid.
Oh my god.
Is he cool?
Raquel, you both hug each other so tightly, but it's so comforting in a time of such disarray. Uh-huh. And he picks you up and he does a little spin with you, happy to see that you're okay.
No.
And then he looks down at her, or he doesn't look down, sorry. You can see he's still wearing a blindfold. But
wait, why is he wearing a blindfold?
Do you not know?
No, I just saw him.
He hasn't really worn this in front of you that much, but you've definitely seen him in it before. You can ask him about it. But Katsuo, okay, if you ask him, he tries to start like explaining it, but keeps getting distracted. To which Katsuo like puts a hand over his shoulder and is like, yeah. He's kind of scared of demons and can't look at any of them, or he freezes up. Hanabi,
I thought he got eye surgery.
Hanabi leans and puts a hand like a bear grip claw on Atsuhiko's shoulder and is like, I have told him countless times to take it off or he'll never get over his fear, but he won't relent.
I don't want to hear it from you.
They both begin, like, poking fun at Atsuhiko being a coward and saying, like, he's the most cowardly demon slayer I've ever seen. Especially
that's so mean. Most fuck off.
Especially the most cowardly one I've seen who can actually slay demons.
Well, your outfit's ugly. Fuck you.
Oh, my God.
And you don't know... I know more about American Girl dolls than you do, genius.
Than you. As I'm in an elegant clothing, be like, bitch.
All right, where would you guys like
your
to go?
Your outfits are ugly.
Do you guys? What would you guys
right,
like to do?
I think, right?
To the right, to the right.
All
right,
move where you'd like
to.
The three of them are also searching, but Mitsurugi, whoever else, is going to lead.
Leader!
I like that no one said hi to me. Good, because I hate these bitches.
Oh, well...
Well, maybe because you didn't say hi to them.
I was going to say... Katsuo?
Yeah, sorry, I was holding my wound.
Did you
I was holding my open wound.
Did you want to look at Katsuo? Because I didn't know if you would say anything to him.
I was thinking that I was kind of rolling my eyes at Hatsuhiko and Hanabi because I fucking hate them. And then I saw that Katsuo was there, and I kind of, like, give him a little wave.
If you look over at him, he's not looking at anyone when he's talking, but when you'll occasionally catch him, like, glancing at you. And you guys eventually catch the same, like, eye glances. And as you wave to him, he, like, sheepishly waves back.
Wait. Jordan.
I'm putting it in my pocket. What?
Do you want me to use my first aid kit on you to help you?
I do have an open wound right now.
Alright, let me stitch you up, girly pop.
Thank you so much.
Bye. I put a little heart band-aid on it.
Aww. Alright.
Do I get any HP back from
that? Are we ready? Where are we going?
Ready to get
Do I have to roll something?
Do I get HP back or am I just not bleeding?
You get HP back. You get a D20 plus medicine.
D20.
Plus, I roll it?
No, she rolls. Or you roll it, but you add her medicine. Or never mind.
24.
If she's administering it, I'll let her do that. You are A-okay, Jordan.
I'm so good, besties.
You guys
better not automatically get hurt again, okay? I wasted both things.
You guys hear from down the hall that the operation is ready to commence.
Oh my god.
Wait, what do you mean down the hall? Down this hall or down, like, up? That's up the hall, not down the hall.
Sorry. It's... Fuck you! What do you guys want to do?
Which hallway is it?
Up the hall.
Yeah, we're going.
Yeah, let's go.
Up.
Let's go, girls.
And it's up.
Let's go, girls.
Let's go, squirrels.
Can you guys give me sneak checks? Brennan.
What's that?
You what?
Stealth.
Are you gonna fucking kill me?
Stealth?
We don't have stealth.
What the fuck do we have in this? Oh, sorry. Cunning.
Mass?
Cunting?
No. Cunning or swiftness.
Yes. How much cunning do you have?
Wait, cunning or swiftness?
Yeah.
Oh, I have both.
Swiftness.
Like, one.
Hey, Taylor's swiftness.
Oh, I got 16. 20. I got a dirty 20.
Woo! Dirty 20.
Don't look at me. Don't look at me.
Are you gonna six?
Damn, this hallway long.
So what did we all get? Who got what?
I got a 16.
Who got a 20?
I got a dirty 20.
Jordan, you hear, as soon as you get to this door, everyone is moved and everything. You guys hear, all right, ma'am, in 12 seconds, the Blood Demon Art will take place, and everything will go according to plan. You hear her like, oh, I'm so excited.
Oh my god.
And as you peer in, you can see she, unconscious.
I'm gonna get fucking sacrificed.
On a nearby operating table.
Wait, Grant, can I just say something real quick?
Yes.
Are we retconning this map that there's not a wall in between us?
No, I mean, sorry, there's not a door, but this is the doorway. You just needed to get to the doorway.
No, no, but
this is the wall. You had to go around.
No, this is, sorry, this is lower.
Okay.
This is an observatory.
Look in.
Yeah.
Okay.
It's almost like stadium-like in a way.
Sure. Oh my god.
It's almost like a boss fight.
Can we jump into it, or do we have to walk around?
You can jump into it, absolutely.
So was there any more information you were going to give us?
Yeah.
I was waiting for the bot, but since you didn't say anything.
Oh, I forgot to put...
We'll definitely have to...
The grieving
moon.
You
also have to adjust the map on the
screen. Oh, I do. Yeah. You're so correct.
That'll let the people see the action. There we go.
Fellas. I do have
Wait, hang on. Grant's not done explaining. Wait, hang on.
Grant, let me kiss you.
The grieving moon laid out on a table opposite to Chi has drawn back some of her clothing, at least areas around her face and head. You can see Chi has had her upper body exposed, not down to anything inappropriate, but just the bust up. One of the demons at hand has what appears to be some kind of demonic tool infused with demon blood that takes on the visage of a surgical knife. He dons mask and gloves either for actual ritual purposes or for cosmetic. And again, just a reiteration, lets the grieving moon know that in 12 seconds, the blood demon art will take effect and everything will go according to plan. The grieving moon makes noises, cheers almost in her excitement.
Is there wires connected to them?
No, they're laid out almost like sitting up almost. I'm trying to describe a slanted table so that they can kind of see each other.
I gotcha. They're facing each other.
That means you guys have 3 rounds to save Chi.
Oh my god!
And I'm going to have...
Is anyone strapped into these tables, or is everyone free-floating?
What do you mean, strapped in?
Something's just holding Chi down. And no, there's nothing holding Chi down.
And there's nothing holding the moon down, either?
No.
Hmm.
So everyone is going to roll initiative.
What's that?
Yeah. Here we go. Speed, Raquel.
Huh?
Speed.
Speed, well, why didn't we call it speed?
Because we're not rolling for speed, we're rolling initiative, but we roll speed to get our initiative.
Oh, okay.
All right.
Well, then we're rolling speed.
A 5? That's what I got last time.
All right.
Wait,
so
I didn't put any of my emojis on.
20.
I feel so sick.
Ah, I didn't mean to do that.
Is she unconscious?
At the moment, yes.
That's so ugly.
And then I get to roll for the boys.
The boys. This one's for the boys back home.
For the booming system.
Ooh! Rengoku.
No, wait, we both have 20.
Oh my god. When they're linked.
Twinsies!
Oh my god, cute.
And then finally for Hanabi, a 22.
Also another 22.
Yeah. Starting us off, the grieving moon is going to elect to do nothing. She is awaiting her transfiguration. Afterward, we get to go to Hanabi and Katsuo. Hanabi is going to move 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And Katsuo is going to move 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And I am going to go to Sheets so I can get my breathing forms.
Sheets?
Google Sheets.
Sheets.
Breathing forms.
There,
your bed sheet.
There is thunder breathing, fifth form. Heat lightning, and you guys can hear.
Whoa, he's attacking.
Along with, you watch as Hanabi charges forward. He leaps over. You 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and he is using Peony of Futility or Flower Breathing, Form 4.
Wait, I thought he was Thunder Breathing.
Hanabi or Katsuo?
Hanabi is. Katsuo is.
Oh, you said thunder breathing and then.
So both of these boys are going to kill in one go.
Well,
it is a great start, truly. I need to make sure I have the right damages. Okay, here it is. So Katsuo is dealing heat lightning. So he's dashing forward with 3d8 plus his force. 1, 2, 3. Or sorry. He's not using heat lightning then. He's using thunderclap and flash. Nope. I guess he is using he's using distant thunder, and he's going to hit for 3d8 at a distance. So Katsuo, that's not a d6. 3d8 plus 5. 18. He slices this thing's fucking head off, and it disappears. Yay. Hanabi, using Peony of Futility.
Good. Peony weenie.
9d4.
Penis.
Futility.
Plus his finesse. 27. This thing is hit 9 consecutive times and is immediately dispersed to ash.
What an overkill.
Atsuhiko's gonna move with you. 1, 2, 3, 4. Sorry, wait. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Where are you going, Tsukihi?
1, 2, 3. Can I just jump over the thing?
Mm-hmm.
It's 6 spaces.
Go for it.
Hey guys. Hey boys.
Alright. Are you attacking anyone? You can move after you've attacked.
Attack after you move.
Or attack after you move, sorry.
I get attack after I move. Nenny. Kind of want to save my girly Chi.
Mm-hmm.
Don't know.
Can I grab her?
You can try to.
What do you mean, try to?
Do you just go out and grab her?
Well, like, what happens if I do?
Did you use all of your movement?
Did I use all my what?
Movement.
Well, I use 6.
Okay, so you can't move anymore. You can't reach G.
Oh, okay, so now I guess I'll attack someone.
Who do you want to attack?
Mr. 12. No, right. Yeah, Mr. 12 on the right.
Okay.
Mr. 305. Mr. 305! I would never do that to Pitbull.
What do you want to use?
I'm gonna use Blade. Wait. Am I that close? Hold on. It's only... shit. I gotta use some. Oh, shit. Oh, fuck. They're the same. Alright, hold on.
Oh my god.
The one I wanted to use was only 5 feet. Damn, I could only do 5 or fucking 30. Jeez. No middle ground.
What are you trying to use?
Yeah, at first I was going to use Blazing Universe, but that's only 5 feet, and everything else is either 30 feet or 20. I don't have 10.
And you can use Flame Tiger as a ranged attack.
I know, but that's a lot of stamina.
Fair enough.
And I... Ugh.
It is a ranged attack.
I guess I'll use that one.
Alright, go for it.
Please. Flame Tiger.
Alright, Flame Tiger on the 12.
Mr. Righty.
Go for it. How much damage? Take off your stamina first, obviously.
No! okay.
And Soften, what did you get for initiative? 9.
I got 14.
So you are next. So go ahead and move.
Is Atsuhiko going?
Did I not kill
Atsuhiko
him?
Atsuhiko moved his movement. No, Raquel, as you slash forward and the flames emit off your blade, firing off a tiger-like being that leaps forward and rends this guy's arm off his body. It doesn't quite decapitate him or kill him. No.
That's mean.
You don't get to move with it. It's a ranged.
I thought I moved!
It's a ranged attack.
Alright, I'll stay here. That's fine.
Alright. Next up, Soften. He moved. Do you want to use an attack?
I'm going to turn to Atsuhiko and Mitsurugi and ask them which of you is the most accurate.
You look at Mitsurugi and a blindfolded Atsuhiko, and Atsuhiko turns his blindfolded body to Mitsurugi and goes, are you going to tell him or should I?
You can tell him.
Okay. No, I really... honestly, I think this might be a friend thing.
I literally know Atsuhiko.
I'm going to... Fine. Give Mitsurugi one of my Molotov cocktails. And...
Why?
I'm going to say, when I give the signal, please, please light it and use it in my direction.
You can, but okay, please.
And then I sprint off this way, but sneak.
No, you can't move that much.
You can't move that much, you little dumbass.
As sneak as I can. You sneak.
I'll let you stay where you are. Next round, you can move that far. Jordan, before your turn, we have one demon that's going to attack Katsuo. And these two other demons that are going to attack Hanabi and Tsukihi, you see that they are clad in doctoral and other medical staff.
Shouldn't Mr. 15 go first?
No, he's actually not moving. You can see his turn. He's using it to prepare the moon and Chi. He's moved over to Chi, and he's not cutting her, but he's placing what appears to be a preparatory line that they would make with marker during surgeries. He's outlining with this knife magical outlines of her features, part of her, like her under eye, her mouth, where her chin is, every point of her. And that is his one turn for this round. The other ones are going to attack Katsuo, Tsukihi, and Hanabi. They are wearing rings, and these rings immediately fire off their body as they aim their arms.
Iron Man.
So, Hanabi. This one is going to attack Hanabi. Hanabi dodges it. Just narrowly avoids with his AC. Well, it's not narrowly. This ring flies past him and literally buries through the rock behind him. If that isn't a greater indication of the strength of this move, I don't know what is, but this is not a move you want to get hit by. Next, Katsuo, who's using a reaction point, and immediately you watch a visage of thunder disappear for a moment before he reappears on the ledge above as the other ring flies through. Soften, Atsuhiko, and Mitsurugi watch as a ring comes through the ground from this direction and buries into the ceiling above, spinning at such a high speed. Atsuhiko jumps a little bit with like a, as you hear this thing fly by him. And finally, Tsukihi, finesse check or reaction point?
Reaction point.
All right. Go ahead and move wherever you please.
This is the lowest thing I have.
That's fair.
Not taking risks. How far can I move? 6?
Yeah.
Oh, sorry, I didn't mean to do that. My name is just very large. Wait, I can't move. Sorry, I didn't know what box that was in. Can I just move 3? Do I have to move all?
No. You can move however many you want.
I'll be right here. Oh, nope.
So you're on the ledge now. Okay.
I'm on the ledge. Boom.
All right. Mitsurugi. Did you move?
Hi. I did not. That's where I was, because I was right at the door.
What do you want to do?
So, I want to... one second. I'm going to use... la, 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 la. Wait, I didn't check this. Wait, hang on. Yeah, I'm gonna use... I have my thing on two different sheets. I'm gonna use,
a move?
Shut up! I'm gonna use Water Splash, and I'm going to go get Chi and run back over here.
Alright, you use that, take off the stamina, but as soon as you arrive at Chi and you reach out to touch her, Jordan, I want you to know that this is not personal.
Yes, it fucking is.
Jordan, you reach your hand out, and as Mitsurugi gets within, like, grip of Chi, his hand flies off. His hand is cut right at the base of the palm, and...
The palm?
His body, like, flies back.
You mean the wrist?
Or the wrist, I'm sorry. Right, guess, well, at the base of the palm is the wrist, so fuck off.
Well, the palm is the center.
Yeah, but at the base of it, at the bottom of it.
That's just the wrist. There's no such thing as the base of the palm.
I hate you. I hate you, and I wish I cut your hand off.
Well, I didn't do those fucking moves.
All right, but yeah, Jordan.
Yes?
Mitsurugi's hand.
Which hand?
His left.
You get to pick. Okay.
I'm putting this as not a full reference, but his hand.
Oh my god. Damn. You gotta redraw your
hold on. Hold on. I remind you guys that other healing items exist. Don't panic. Yet.
The demon.
Well, I added it to my reference sheet just in case.
Okay.
That you don't have a hand.
But
that I'm right-handed now.
In top of the order, the grieving moon remains still as she waits for her face to be tracked. 22, both Hanabi and Katsuo are. Katsuo begins charging. First form. Thunderclap and flash, but it does take a round to charge up, and he begins to like yell out to everyone, "There must be something stopping us from touching her! Some preset commands!" Hanabi turning and activating flower breathing, sixth form, and he launches into the air, dropping and absolutely eviscerating the demon, turning it to dust with 3d20. Unless he rolls terribly. Plus. Oh, okay, yeah. He fucking obliterates this thing in front of him. You can hear it very gently as he's like, "Sakura fall." And destroys it with a lateral slash that cuts all the way through. Atsuhiko immediately upon hearing this and seeing what's happened to Mitsurugi. 1, 2, 3... he gets to 3 and immediately activates, where is it? Flame breathing, 9th form, and begins charging Rengoku. He takes on a more serious visage underneath the mask, as if he's seeing everything without actually looking at it. It's going to take him a round, so him and Katsuo are targeting, the demon that's currently like working on Chi and the Grieving Moon. Afterwards, it is Tsukihi, your turn.
So they're targeting this one?
They're targeting
the
Grieving
Moon. Okay. Well, I'll go for this guy. And
Soften, do you want to go with her?
Yeah.
We can go together?
Yeah, as you guys are both attacking, the other demon that's working on Chi has stopped outlining her and has now moved to the Grieving Moon.
Okay, my movement is, don't tell me, Squidward.
30 feet.
Or
six spaces.
It's 30 feet or six spaces.
Wait, can I move my six spaces?
Is that, Gwant?
Yeah.
Is there any way I can dash and double that?
Yeah, you just can't make an action.
So that would be 12.
Mm-hmm.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Wait.
Do you
8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Okay.
What are you doing?
Don't worry about it.
What did you... What would you like to do? What are you doing while running? Are you putting things down?
No.
What are you trying to do?
Do you want me to explain my devious plan?
Yes, because I have to know what you're doing.
All right, Bingus. I was going to wrap her head in the parachute and then light it on fire.
I mean... Okay.
Hood and all. So, like, I was trying to blind her and then just light her eyes on fire.
Do you push it, like, put it over her? Like, try and push it onto her?
Well, we can't.
So, what do you do?
I'm going around behind her.
Okay.
I'm getting ready.
Okay.
And sweaty.
And that's your turn?
Yeah. I mean, can I do more?
Well, depends.
That's kind of okay. It, I guess.
Jordan, Raquel, reaction point or finesse check?
Wait, I have to attack this guy.
Oh, you're right. I'm so sorry.
No. Sorry, I wasn't thinking. I'm gonna do unknowing fire because I don't have that much stamina. All
right, give it to him. How much damage?
13.
13.
14.
This is a different one to the one that you've hit before, I believe.
Okay. No, it's the same one.
Is it the same? All right, if it's the same.
It's the same one.
You slice his head off and kick his chest in as it goes flying and his body turns to ash. The last one.
I bitch.
The last one is now just attacking Mitsurugi.
Cool. Jesus.
Jordan. Finesse check or reaction point?
Let's keep it going. Let's do a finesse check.
All right, God. Go for it.
Just use your reaction. For the love of God.
What if I need them?
For what? For this?
Yeah, for this. Who's attacking me right now? One of the little demons?
Yeah, but like, look at where you're at.
Yeah, 22. I'm fine.
All right. Jordan.
You got it this one.
You have disadvantage, though.
No, you never said that.
Because you have the same health and laceration that you did 10, 20 minutes ago.
No, I don't. I just got healed.
And then you... Oh, no, you did get healed. Never mind. You're right.
Yeah,
you do dodge it. The ring buries through the concrete behind you. And you're fine.
Yeah.
You. It's your turn now. Do what you'd like. Do what you'd please.
I look at my nub for a second and shed a few silent tears. Girl, can I even attack? Like, what? Can I use my sword?
No. You can use basic attacks, but you can't use breathing forms.
Can can I use my my rifle?
Yeah, absolutely.
Okay. Cool.
Guess I'll just shoot at this other 12 guy that needs to be taken care of.
Yeah.
A loaded gun.
The fuck do I roll? What do I roll for my gun? Dexterity?
Finesse.
I do.
Wait, sorry, what are you doing?
Shooting my gun?
Yeah, finesse.
Okay. I be rolling finesse rolls like it's nobody's business. Ooh, another 22! Woo!
22. You're firing at 12.
I prop the rifle up on my nub. Yeah.
Alright, give me damage. Your D8 plus accuracy.
My sheet says D12 plus accuracy.
Oh, sorry, D12.
That's what I thought.
I like, can't even look at the screen, so I'm nervous.
6.
Alright, Jordan. You fire this thing's eye out. Its brain matter sloshing out of its skull as it stumbles for a moment. And we are back to the top of the round.
Oh my fucking god.
So Atsuhiko, Katsuo, and Hanabi. So Hanabi immediately, in a rush, calls out for one of the boys who's ready to fire to just go. As he leaps forward, he uses flower-breathing sixth or fifth form Swirling Peach to deliver a weighted attack after a spin onto the other demon, killing it. Katsuo and Atsuhiko both attack this demon. And as they both launch forward, this thing has chi and the grieving moon beginning to float. And chi, her face begins to glow and illuminate along with the grieving moons before there is one final loud bang down the hallway. I don't know if anyone has seen her or has attempted to look down there and can see her, but she is charging forward all the way into the main hall.
Who the fuck?
You hear bang, 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 bang as several rifle shots ring out, hitting the scalpel out of the demon's hand and knocking its jaw clean off its face as Atsuhiko and Katsuo tear through its chest and upper body. The upper moon, who was going to spend her turn being transformed into a beautiful young woman, is now afflicted with such a rage that she hasn't felt in years, and she drops now several small wrappings of handkerchiefs onto the floor, summoning God knows how many demons to the floor. Summoning God. Sets of three are dropped, all of which are immediately ready to fight. And as this goes down, there is an explosion above you guys. A loud bang. A terrifying bang.
Who is this?
Let's see. Sorry. The fight has ended for the time being as we are about to go on to next week. But allow me to close this off by showing you guys who has joined us round one, or the last round in the order. You hear, "Oh, come on! I was going to get her!"
You're kind of cutting off.
Sorry.
I didn't hear what you said.
A thick-accented girl calls out from behind you in a language you're not very familiar with. You awaken.
Oh my god.
You are held in the arms of what feels like something massive and soft and flannel. As you hear, "Are you all right now?"
Oh my god! I'm gonna say this on stream.
That is my boyfriend.
We end as she finds in the clearing dust and ready demon slayers and demons, a almost 9 foot tall titan of a man stands with eyes that emanate early sunrise, a thick accent, and a rough beard.
Oh my god.
Sorry.
I wish I was
cheating right now. He says, "I'm sorry, young lady. I'm gonna have to put you down."
Ugh. Oh my god. I'm literally
blushing. I'm blushing for you.
Thank you guys so much for coming. Yeah. We will see you all next week.
It's not 11.
It's late enough that we're ending. I hope you all have an amazing next week. And that you're excited for our next session and that you enjoyed this one. If you want to find anyone who's played today, you can check it in the link in the description below. We will see you next week. Anyone want to say anything before we end for the night?